Greetings, Liz. It is I, Tactical Girlfriend. Welcome back to the channel. I hope everybody's doing well. These days, ammunition is still fairly expensive. Prices are kind of going down a little bit, but not very much. It's quite an investment, as always, to get into very large quantities of ammo, and that's all the more reason to make sure that your ammunition is properly stored and protected. So keep that investment safe, and let's talk a little bit more about it. Now, a lot of you are probably keeping your ammo in its original packaging, just stashed away on a shelf or in a box somewhere, and you forget about it for a little bit. That's perfectly okay if we're talking about using the stuff within the next few months. That kind of short-term storage doesn't need much more other than fairly stable temperatures and not huge amounts of water just soaking into the packaging. As long as you avoid any sort of weird catastrophic event like that, this is a perfectly reasonable and okay way to go. I also want to add that a little bit of prep work is really pertinent for going to the range. If you're not keeping your ammo in a tin of some sort, and you have it sitting in your backpack all loose, and you run into some rain, and that gets your backpack wet, that seeps through, gets the cardboard wet, the cardboard disintegrates, and the ammo just gets loose and also wet. That's no good. It's a huge mess. It may actually affect whether your ammo works or not, and that's a huge waste. So make sure that you actually get your ammo put into some Ziploc baggies, make sure that they're airtight, parcel them out however you need to, and then stick them in your backpack. Now, with long-term storage of ammo, things can get a bit more complicated. The first consideration is making sure that you're choosing an appropriate kind of ammunition for long-term storage. Things like steel case rounds are not really good unless they're lacquered. The bare steel itself does invite corrosion. That in turn can cause failures to feed and cycling issues. Also, bare primers can invite moisture into the primer and the powder, thereby compromising those. On the other hand, brass case ammo reduces the chances of getting any corrosion whatsoever, making sure that you have a very reliably cycling round and that things just continue to work. Also, making sure that your primer is sealed, indicated by the colored seal around the primer, can reduce the chances of moisture ever compromising any of the combustible internals of your round. It is really good to know that ammo properly stored away can actually last for a very long time. We're talking decades, even more than 50 years. You can be shooting ancient rounds, and so long as that they are properly stowed away, they should be able to cycle and fire reliably every time. Make sure that you're keeping your ammo stored at a fairly stable temperature. Usually room temperature or a little bit cooler is good. Avoid any extremes, of course, and make sure that it's stored in a very dry place or a very dry manner. Avoid any humidity fluctuations, and if you do these two things, your ammo should last you for a very good long while. If you're keeping your ammo around for a while, you definitely want to make sure it's stored in an airtight container. You don't want it kept in its original box on a shelf all loosey-goosey-like, exposed to the elements. That just won't do for longevity. I recommend using a proper ammo can for this, and there's a lot of different options on the market. Some of the most affordable ones are made out of plastic, and they can be okay. Plastic also can bend, and that can actually defeat the seal. It can also be brittle, and if you crack that, it will also defeat that entire purpose. You can get something that's styled more after something like a Pelican case, where you have very sturdy plastic, multiple latches on different ends, and a really, really good seal. That will actually do the trick pretty darn well. However, I generally like to go the classic route here and just get the military surplus metal cans. These are very robust, very tough. They last for a very long time. They're really good for long-term storage, and that's exactly what they're for. And they're actually really plentiful and affordable. If you do get one of the used military surplus ammo cans, it is important to note that you should check the seal on it. One way to do this is to simply fill a bathtub or a large bucket full of water, take the ammo can, make sure it's sealed, completely submerge it under the water, rotate it on all of its sides, then take it out, dry it off, open it up, and then inspect the interior. If it's dry, you're good to go. If it's wet, you definitely don't want to use that. You can use it for other kinds of storage or just as a fun arts and crafts project. Speaking of the seal, it's important to actually maintain the rubber O-ring gasket around the lid of your ammo can. I generally recommend using a silicone-based lubricant, applying a very thin film around the entire thing. That'll make sure that that rubber doesn't degrade and you get a good seal for many years to come. Definitely avoid using any mineral oil-based lubricants as they can actually eat away at the rubber, and that defeats the entire purpose. Also, with these metal cans, make sure that they're also kept away from moisture. Keep them off the ground, especially if you're in an area that's prone to flooding. And generally keep them in a dry room so that these don't corrode themselves and compromise the integrity of the can. You also need to keep the interior of your ammo can dry. I strongly recommend using some sort of desiccant. Don't use the stuff that comes in whatever package you ordered off the internet. That stuff is disposable, it's a one-time use, and it's probably already used up by the time it got to you. It's not going to do you any good. Investing in something like this is a really, really smart idea. These can actually suck up a lot of water. They also have a really nice indicator window here, where if it's blue, it means you're still good. If it's pink, you can actually throw this in the oven, bake it for a little bit, and it resets and is fully recyclable. These are a very worthwhile investment, and I do strongly recommend you put these in every single ammo can you have. Now, as for how you store the ammo in the ammo can, there's a number of ways you can do it. Nothing really is right or wrong here. It's all a matter of personal preference. You can store your ammo all loose in the can. That's totally fine. You can actually maximize the amount of ammo you can put in a can this way, but it also makes it very prohibitively heavy. You can also keep things in their original packaging. That's totally fine, so long as they're not airtight. I actually personally like using these MTM cases. These are just really good for organization. They're very easy to see what you got in there. They actually come with labels, and that way I can actually identify what I got in my can very easily. The one caveat is that I do recommend drilling holes in the sides of these so that you do have airflow through these, ensuring that there's no moisture trapped in there and the desiccant is doing its work. With regards to the can, I also like to stencil on the kind of rounds that are being stored in there. Just for quick reference, really easy to spot. That way I just make sure I'm grabbing the right one. Also, I like to use the MTM labels that come with those plastic cases. I put those on the cases as well as on the outside of the can. That way I know the brand, the caliber itself, and the weight of the rounds that I'm using. Any pertinent information is really good to have. I also like to keep the original box of the ammo for whatever ammo I'm storing in that can. I fold it flat and then I throw it into the can with the ammo. That way, if I did miss any details, I've at least got a reference for the original packaging if that was ever needed. Now, if you're not thrilled about the idea of getting a bunch of ammo cans, there are alternatives. If you get some Tupperware, so long as it's airtight, you can throw rounds in there and some desiccant and be good to go. Also, you can vacuum seal your ammo, provision them into certain quantities and packets. Those can be handy. However, I don't think that's really a good long-term solution, as the vacuum seal isn't perfect and you can still seal some moisture in there. Well, that wraps up my overview of how I like to store my ammo for the long term. There's a number of different ways of doing this. I'm sure you all have your different ways. You may have criticisms of mine too. If so, I'd love to hear more about it in the comments below. Also, if you enjoyed this video, found it interesting or useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell too. I also want to graciously thank everybody who's supporting this channel on Patreon. You keep the lights on, and I couldn't do this without you. Everything that you see here comes from viewers like you. I don't monetize this channel in any other way. I don't run ads on it. In fact, I've refused to. I hate YouTube ads. I'm sure you do too. If you do want to go help out, you can always go to patreon.com/tacticalgf. The biggest contributors are named at the end of the video. And that's a wrap. I really appreciate you all tuning in. Please be good to each other out there. And as always, please take care. Bye!